Are you working in Smartsuite and needing to create recurring tasks so that you can track what's due and when? Well, in this video, I am breaking down this exact feature. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. And it should come as no surprise that Smartsuite is at the forefront of the no-code tools that we love, especially for organizing and structuring tasks so that things don't fall through the cracks and get lost in the abyss. So in this video, we're gonna be breaking down how you can create recurring tasks inside of Smartsuite, and we're gonna come at this from two very different perspectives, two different methodologies that you might use based on how you've structured your Smartsuite setup. But before we get to that, I want to first invite you to follow along with this video. If you already have a Smartsuite account, pop it open in another window and follow along as we go through this. And if you haven't already signed up for Smartsuite, check out our link below. If you sign up using our link and you choose in the future to upgrade to a paid account, then you will be eligible for some exclusive swag that only comes to members that watch videos and go through that on our channel. So if that's of interest, grab that link below. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this and break down the two key ways that you can set up recurring tasks in Smartsuite. Now, jumping into my screen, we're gonna look at our sales CRM. This is a template that we've already installed from the library. Smartsuite has an extensive number of templates available for us in that library, so explore that on your own time, and if you want to follow along, get set up with that sales CRM. I'm in the opportunities application. So inside of here, you'll notice that we have these different opportunities broken down, and one thing I want to draw your attention to, because it has to do with the first way that we're going to create these recurring tasks, is this little section right here. This field is called Next Actions, and if we click into this, we're gonna see a checklist of things. I can hover over this checklist and you'll see that, hey, look, I've got a checklist here where I can, you know, determine what the next steps are for this particular objective, for this particular opportunity. So here I could say, okay, this is done. And as soon as I do that, I'm getting some of the bar filled out, so I'm 50% now complete on my next actions. And if I save those changes, that's gonna show up here at a high level. Now, the reason that I start by breaking down this particular checklist is because one of the ways that we can bring in recurring tasks is actually in a checklist just like this. So this particular checklist is a manual one. It's been set up and structured. Actually, let's go to the settings for this. You'll notice that users are not allowed to modify or delete the default entries, but if we go over to defaults here, we don't have any defaults. Defaults are the area that you can implement a template so that every time a new record comes into existence, that template of tasks or checklist items is automatically created. So this is the first way that we can do this, but you'll notice that this particular field for next actions, this is manual. The intent here is that I can come in and say, oh, I've got a new task. I'm gonna add a manual new task. I might even assign that to myself or someone else on my team. I'll give it a due date as well. And doing these two elements of the recurring task, both a due date and assigning it to somebody, will ensure that it shows up in the My Work section so that these people, as they're added to these different tasks, actually see this information up in My Work. So if we go up to My Work here, we can actually see that that task is now added. We can go into our upcoming section here, and there it is, the opportunity under Peak Partners Client Portal. Next action is this new task. And if I want to close this out, I can do that right here from My Work. And of course, this is one of those amazing features of Smartsuite that allows us to manage all of our tasks across multiple different applications all in one place. So now that I've handled that, if we go back, we're gonna actually see that on that checklist, that item has been marked complete. And again, this is all possible because we've assigned it to somebody and given it a due date, allowing it to show up in My Work. So let's imagine that every time we create a new opportunity inside of this application, we want it to start with a defaulted template of certain checklist items that have to occur. So what we can do here is actually add a new field. I'll click here and I will say, add a new field to the right. And we're going to make it the checklist field type. So on the checklist, now we can go in and say template of tasks. The important part is to roll over now into the default setting, and we can add the list of things that have to occur as we build a new opportunity. So this is thing one, add thing two, add thing three, you get the idea. So now, once we set these defaults, we have the opportunity to choose if users can create additional or new entries, and also decide if users can modify and delete the default entries that we've created. So this will depend on how rigid your template is. If you have to go through those same steps every time, you will want to modify this, click that button, so that people cannot delete those templated items. All right, once we're set up here, we can go ahead and add this field, and we will now have that field created. Of course, the existing records will not, by default, take on those default settings. It's only when we create a new record that it's automatically going to add those tasks. But the thing you'll notice is that this method does not allow us to assign these tasks yet to people on our team. This is one area where, unfortunately, the default settings do not give us the capability that we are looking for. So another opportunity for us is to instead create an automation around this. Rather than just establishing default settings here, let's instead take those defaults away. We'll go to defaults here. I'm going to erase all these things, and let's go and update this field. Now I'm going to move into my automations, and I will simply build an automation that says, when a new opportunity is created, so a record inside of my opportunities application, so record created right here, opportunities is the app that I want to be watching for this particular automation, and that's it. So when that record comes into existence, then I want to do something, and here we go, I can go ahead and update that record. So we make that selection here, give SmartSuite just a minute to catch up with us. And now we want to choose the fields that we wish to update. In our case, we have that new field that we created called Template of Tasks. And this is the one where we want to bring stuff in. Now with the automation, you'll notice that I have a lot more control. So here's where I can say thing one, and I can add a due date here. And the cool part about SmartSuite automations is I can make the due date relative to today inside of my automation. So I can say something like date action tomorrow, for example. And I can assign this to somebody inside of my organization. Or alternatively, I could also back up here and look at members from the trigger. So if there were elements in my automation trigger that I wanted to include in assigning people to certain tasks, I can bring them in from that trigger as well. In our case, I'll just imagine that every time a new record is created inside of opportunities, I'm going to get some work assigned to me. So I'm going to go ahead and plug that in. And my first thing, thing one, is going to be due tomorrow relative to whatever day the automation runs. So this is great. I'm all set here. Now to make this easier, if I'm adding multiple tasks, I can simply duplicate this action. Now I can go ahead and drill into the next task that I need to create. And in this case, it might be thing two. I'm very creative. And I'll go back to my due date here. And maybe I want to change this up. I want this to be several days from today. So I might say, pick today, but actually add 5 days to it. So this will happen 5 days after the day that the automation runs. And again, will be assigned to me. Let's just take those two examples here. Now, before I run this automation, of course, I have to add the automation, and of course, I need to also switch it on. I strongly recommend that you also rename your automation here so that you can make sure that you stay organized as you get a long list of automations. Now, as of this recording, it is January 26th. So let's make sure that those dates are actually relative to today as we suggested as we built them up. Now, the first thing we need to do is add an opportunity here, and I will call this new opportunity. And this will trigger our automation. If you recall, the automation is set to trigger whenever a new record enters the opportunities application. So I can scroll on over and we see that one task has already been created. And as I was speaking, the second one came in as well. I can open this up and take a look and we can check the dates. And sure enough, they line up as we had planned. This one is due tomorrow, a day after the day of recording. So the 27th, I'm recording on the 26th. And this one is 5 days from now. In 5 days, my second thing is due. So this is a great way to bring in tasks. You can again assign dates to them as well as who is in charge of these things in the checklist. Now, my second option is actually very similar to this, except we are going to track our tasks in a different application. And so very often you might want to create an application that is built to actually just store task data. So let's actually try this one on for size. Rather than using a checklist, which is what I've done here, a checklist being its own field, and essentially a compound field because it's got subfields inside of it, well, we might just instead create a different application and call it tasks. So here I will have a brand new application and I can connect this up to my opportunities through a linked relationship. And so I can just go ahead and link here to another record. I'll rename this opportunities. And of course, I choose the opportunities from the options here. So I need to link up to that different application, and I will say that, look, every task that I create will link to one opportunity. Let's go ahead and establish that connection. And now I can simply go back once this link is built, and I can start adding new opportunities here based on what I have in my opportunities table. So I can say, well, this task relates to the opportunity, and so I can find an opportunity here like strategic partnership, include it here, and again, I have the ability to assign this to somebody, assign a priority, so I can actually get more granular here and decide if this is high importance or otherwise. I also have status that's going to track against the progress of this thing, and finally, I have my due date here. So when is this particular task going to be due? Now, the same rules apply here. If I want to create automation, I do it in much the same way as I did with my checklist automation. So popping back into our automations here, what I could do is create an additional automation that functions very similarly to the last one. I would say when a record is created in our opportunities application, I make the selection here, and then I would create new records in our tasks application. So again, these would be recurring things that would happen on some sort of a schedule. Now, one closing thought that I have for you here is that sometimes when you create new things, new tasks, they might not be related to the creation of an opportunity or some other business function. They might be instead related to a date. So it could be that you do something every 2 weeks or on the 10th of every month, and you need to create a task so that you can be sure to keep on track. Well, for this, SmartSuite has gotten ahead of us and has created a special trigger just for this use case. There is the at scheduled time, which is currently in beta. Let's go ahead and change that trigger so that you can see how to implement this particular solution. Here we are going to establish what app we are working with, although this doesn't have such a high priority. What really matters in this trigger is the cadence or the frequency of the trigger. So with what frequency do we want this to repeat? And also, is this happening on an hourly basis, daily, weekly, monthly, or just one time? So in our example, if we wanted to make this on the 10th of every month, we would simply say, this has to repeat every 1 month on the 10th at a particular date and time. So go ahead and make your selections here, and we can then set this up. So here it's saying this would be starting from the 26th. I would, of course, change this to say, well, because we're on January 26th, I'm going to say start this on the 10th of February, and we should be good to go. So the rule will be executed on February 10th at 9 a.m. And if we want to see the next 10 runs for this, we can highlight here and take a look. Now you'll see I have two dates selected on the calendar right now, so I have to make sure to uncheck these dates. Otherwise, I will be stuck running this thing twice. So let's make sure that we've only selected the 10th. And once we've got that properly selected, we can then look at the next 10 runs and make sure that these are the days that we expected to see here. So now this automation will trigger at 10 a.m. or 9 a.m. on the 10th day of every month. And bear in mind that the reason for that time difference here has to do with daylight savings. So if we're falling back or springing forward on that particular month, we're going to be in a different time zone if you are subject to daylight savings time. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. I know we went relatively quickly, so if you have questions that I didn't answer, feel free to drop them below. Of course, check out SmartSuite if you haven't already using the affiliate link that I mentioned at the beginning of this video. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing to this channel so that you can stay up to date on no-code news just like this. That's it for this one. Until next time, keep on building.